leave, to me, there's stuff happening inside of these filaments. Very active inside. The filament to me is not the primary issue, it's what's inside the filament. And there is a world of activity going on here, and I will tell you that everything says that it's biological activity. Okay? This is not some kind of, this is a very complex arrangement. And we're talking about pre-high magnification, and there's tremendous substructure taking place here. And there is biology here. This is about 8,000 by 8,000 magnification. I have to bring up something for you. There's a lot of structure going on inside. It's very small. We're talking, okay, frame of comparison. Asbestos fiber, okay, back up. Human hair, about 60 microns in thickness of bare hair. Asbestos fibers, about 2 microns in thickness. Do any of you, remember any concern about having asbestos fibers in the environment? Medical thing, okay, 2 microns thick. This material here will measure at less than a micron in thickness. Okay. You should be asking some questions right away. Unexplained, unidentified, submicron filament environment, repeated presence, international. The word you that came up, responsibility. Okay, I need to point out right here. Do you see the little circles in there? Okay, this is really pushing in terms of what my scoping equipment can do. This is the first time that I can teeter on that edge of what you call nanotechnology. People use the word nanotechnology very loosely without an understanding what that really means. We don't actually have access to tools that allow us to see nanotechnology in a ready fashion. I'm skirting the edge right there. Those little dots will measure about 250 nanometers, about a quarter of a micron, those little bitty dots right there. Those little bitty dots are extremely important to me. Can I summarize it? You remember I mentioned this health condition called the Morgellons and how that's been treated and handled over the years. Those little dots, from my position as an independent researcher over the last 20 years, are at the very crux and heart of the existence of the Morgellons condition. Absolute heart. Ever since I saw that little dot, I was always very interested, because that little dot is not just a little dot. The research would say that it is most likely of the bacterial class. It is alive. It is biology. And I don't claim things with certainty that I can't, that I'm not able to justify. But I will say there's very strong evidence that the nature and behavior of this material, I've cultured it, I've studied this particular microorganism extensively. It has, let's say, very, very strong hints of what you would call genetic engineering, unusual biological characteristics.